I think if there's anything that I've learned about Jesus in the years of walking with him is that he's the best person that we could ever know in the midst of our suffering. Right? Because he suffered too. He suffered for us so that we could know that we are never, ever alone in the heights of our joy or in the depths of our suffering. And I'm so grateful for that truth. So this next song that I'm going to sing for y'all, my dad started writing in the 1970s. So we finished up about 2 years ago. And it's this beautiful prayer. It comes out of Psalm 19. And if you haven't read that lately, it's just, it's poetry. It's beautiful. And it's just asking God to help the words. Our words are powerful, right? So it's just this prayer asking him to help the words that come out of our mouths and then the things that our hearts kind of fix themselves on and wrap themselves around to bring about life and light and not the opposite of that. And do y'all like to sing?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'd love it if you'd sing this prayer with me. And I know y'all are like, hey, Ellie, nice to meet you. I've never heard your music before. I don't know this song. It's cool. It's fine. I'll sing the chorus 3 times. And if you wanted to join in on the last chorus, I'd just love it. This is May the Words. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock. You are my rock, O Lord, my rock, my redeemer. Well, the heavens, they declare what you have done, and the dark is chased away by the rising sun. But even in the darkest nights, the stars shine on. Creation sings redemption song. Sounded real good. That was awesome.